We welcome you all and thank you for coming early in the morning. We'll start the program now and we have quite a few sessions ahead. So we would try our best to keep to the time. We have already started a little late. But nonetheless, with the cooperation of the participants in the roundtable, I'm sure we'll finish in time. I'll let Shweta introduce the program now.
Good morning and welcome everybody. I thank each one of you for coming to this 3-day roundtable on emerging frontiers of the labor movement. My name is Pritha Chatterjee and I work in ActionAid on issues of urbanization and urban poverty. I'll give a brief introduction about ActionAid and Urban Action School and Worker Solidarity Network and the context for having this roundtable for the next 3 days. So ActionAid has a consistent history of working on the different issues of labor and employment with particular focus on informal or unorganized sector workers. Our major areas of intervention have been around the recognition of informal workers, minimum wages, access and availability of social security and skill building, etc. We work through different platforms such as the Working People's Charter, Worker Solidarity Network and the Urban Action School, and through our different partners across 12 states. And as we all know, labor and unemployment are the most crucial components of urbanization and cities in today's world, and there needs to be a conversation between the different representatives of different sectors of workers. The Urban Action School and ActionAid have hosted courses on the labor and informal sector in 2015. This course specifically focused on questions and issues related to the informal sector, including social protection, minimum wage, decent work, and unpaid work as well. It also delved into the different sectors of informal work, such as construction, industry, agriculture, street vending, and domestic work. Skill development as a means to upgrade knowledge and job opportunities in the informal sector was also discussed. This roundtable on the emerging frontiers of labor movement in India aims to facilitate a dialogue and the experiences and struggles of workers across the country and across different sectors to share their insights, experiences, strategies, and not only amongst the trade union leaders, but also activists, researchers, academicians coming together from different parts of the country. For us, this roundtable is crucial, particularly in the context of discussing the agenda of work with special reference to decent work and women and work, and secondly, to collectively build a progressive future of labor in the city. I request all of you to interact and be active on all the 3 days, and please thank you so much for coming. I will now request Vaibhav to introduce the keynote speaker and carry on with the.
Thank you, Prasad. Quickly try to introduce the idea behind the program. First of all, a couple of lines about the Workers Solidarity Network, which I represent in this program. The Workers Solidarity Network is a loose collective of mainly academics and also some activists. The idea is to get theory to talk to the movement in a very consistent way. So we are doing a few things through the network, one of which is to organize such roundtables to help facilitate a dialogue between the movement and the people who work on labor. The fundamental question here is, and I'll come to the program, but the question that we have been tackling while conceiving the program and while talking to people who we have invited to speak, because you can see the people who are invited, the main speakers, the participants, everybody has a very rich history behind them, huge organizations that they represent, and very successful struggles that they have done over the last many, many years. Why should they come to this program is a big question. I think, and we believe that the understanding behind organizing this kind of a mixed group of formal and informal sector, of trade unions and academics together, was to be able to, first of all, look forward in a way where a lot of times when such discussions happen, we end up, I won't want to use the word, but a lot of time it's an examination of what happened in the past. why we failed, what didn't work out. But here I would request all the speakers and the participants to focus more on the success parts. What worked for us? For instance, in railways, in banking, for the informal sector, people are here because, and you know, a lot of people would notice that very key sectors are also missing from the panels that we have organized. There is construction sector is missing from the informal sector. I mean, in the public sector, there are many more. We could not get someone from insurance to come and speak for instance. That was more a logistical thing. But at the same time, it still is a complete panel in our understanding, because the idea is to look at common strategies, common agendas across sectors, across ideologies, across geographies also, because in Delhi, a lot of times you don't see programs like this discussing trade union movement and what happens on the ground in labor politics. So it's also a good experience for people like us in Delhi to get some exposure to what people in Bombay do, what people in Tamil Nadu are doing, and so on. So first of all, I would request all the speakers and participants to look forward and try to help us figure out what has worked for the labor movement in the country. We will talk about the government and what the government is doing. That will surely be a part of everything. But at the same time, we'd also like to, in some way, contribute to the government's agenda of making the condition of labor better. As to the program, it's a 3-day program. I think all of you have seen the schedule. Each session is about 1.5 hours, and we have tried to give lesser time to speakers and more time to discussions. So this is something new that we are experimenting. So I would apologize to the speakers. They'll get about 10 to 15 minutes to present their case, but we'll have about at least 1/2 hour of discussion in every session, which is why the role of the other participants is very, very important here. And I'm glad that so many of you are here, people who are stalwarts in their field. We really don't need speakers, and participants will be a common thing, it will be a discussion. The rest of the things I'll leave to the rest of the sessions, and I'll come before every session to make a few points. We also have among us Baba Adab, who has been our leader in the work that ActionAid mainly does on labor. And I would like to, like Pritha pointed out, our main focus has been to work with the informal sector and develop an agenda, a manifesto, a charter for the informal workers in the country. And Baba has helped us leading from the front to bring together a lot of informal sector unions, organizations together, and develop a common agenda on social security that we have been taking to different parts of the country. Just a small note, there is often this distinction that there will be a meeting which will be of trade unions, there will be a meeting which will be of NGOs, and there will be a meeting of academics and so on. We are trying to blur the boundaries a little bit here, especially in terms of which organizations can represent labor. That's also a big question given the level of informality that our country sees. So you will see NGOs talking about labor, you will see women's collectives talking about labor in our program. So we have tried to break out of the straitjacket in that sense, and I'm glad that all the mainstream trade unions have accepted the invitation and have accepted to engage. And we see this as a very good point for our work and our campaign to bring the informal and the formal together, that these conversations can happen and maybe something will come out of it. We look forward to the 3 days. I would request Baba to come and deliver the welcome address.